आनंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the living and practicing Hindus, de facto Kailashians all over the world. I welcome all the Sarvanya Peeta Kartas, Yajamans, Manifestors, Paripavrityagis, Sri Mahans, Mahans, Kotari, Danedar, Visitors, Viewers, Kayakalpa Yoga Participants, Kailasas E-Gurukul Students, Kailasas NHU Students, Kailasas Ministers, Ambassadors, Diplomates, E-Diplomates, Citizens, Consulate Generals and Supporters, Mantreshwaras, Vidyeshwaras, Ganeshwaras, Lokeshwaras, Astreshwaras, all those sitting with us live on Kailasas NTV, I welcome all of you with my love and respect. Paramashiva's message directly from Kailasa. Listen. Manifest peace in your being level, powerfulness in your doing level, intensity in your action. This is the most important, powerful, royal secret to manifest the success in life. Listen carefully. Manifest peace in your being, powerfulness in your doing, will in your doing, intensity in your act. Listen intensely. Society always teaches you pseudo dignity instead of integrity. Cosmos teaches you integrity, society teaches you pseudo dignity. Pseudo dignity cannot replace the strength of integrity. Same way, peace and powerfulness cannot be replaced by your idea of happiness. All the idea of happiness taught to you by society is pseudo happiness. Understand, the good news I have for all of you is joy, pain, happiness, sadness, both are delusion.
both are pseudo ideas taught to you by society. How society teaches you pseudo dignity, it teaches you the pseudo happiness, pseudo sadness. Idea of happiness which you carry, for which you are asked to run your life, an idea of pain you carry, for which you are asked to run your life to avoid the pain. To avoid the pain, you are asked to run your life. Both are absolutely pseudo and stupid. Listen carefully. If you fundamentally remove the pus from your core cognitions of life, if you detox yourself from the ideas of pseudo dignity, pseudo pain, pseudo happiness, your life is successful. Your life will be successful. What is happiness? The whole idea of happiness and pain is just delusion. Some accidental irreproducible, because irreproducible, most unscientific. Anything which can be definite and reproducible only is science. If something should be called as science, it should be very definitive and reproducible. But all your happiness and your pain, both are not reproducible. They are not definite. It is just some chemistry happening in your biology, like accident, some coincidence. Sometimes it happens and sometimes it doesn't happen. And you struggle with the idea what all you did earlier to get the happiness. You try to do the same thing and wait, even beg for happiness to come, and it doesn't come. Same way, you plan what all you did to avoid some pain or sadness, and you avoid all of that perfectly. But suddenly that sadness is vibrant, literally taking over you, paralyzing you. You don't know. I tell you, peace is the real experience. Powerfulness is the real experience. They both are definite and reproducible. Integrity is definite. Pseudo dignity is delusory. Peace is definite. Happiness is delusory. Powerfulness is definite. Fear of pain or fear of sadness is delusory. Understand, this year, 2021, this is my message. Listen, today is not only new year, beginning of the new decade. Beginning of the new decade of this century. And from spiritual angle, literally beginning of the new era after the pralaya, after the great deluge. So listen to this message very carefully. This is direct message from Paramashiva for this whole year, for this whole decade, for this whole new life post pralaya.
to understand listen carefully intensely work more and more to have peace in your being manifest powerfulness in your will and doing level manifest intensity in your action these are the definitive methods royal secrets for manifesting success in your life in any field don't go for pseudo dignity don't go for pseudo happiness Don't be afraid of pseudo pain. Listen, listen intensely. Always look for peace in your being level. Don't search, seek, try to look for joy or happiness in your being your constant deep yearning craving attachment to the joy is the source of pain because joy is neither definite nor reproducible when buddha said life is pain he means this life is not actually pain you are unscientific craving you are deluded attachment you are extremely stupid lust for joy happiness is the source of all pain look for peace not for joy peace is a definite experience shanti is the definite experience reproducible scientific and strengthening your existence making you feel more and more grounded alive empowering you understand your search for joy and happiness does not empower you your search for peace empowers you gives you the experience of success it makes you taste success in the life bring powerfulness in your doing in your will Do not go after pseudo dignity. Go after integrity. Society teaches you pseudo dignity in the place of integrity. Cosmos expects integrity from you, not pseudo dignity. I tell you, anyone who bothers about pseudo dignity will be paralyzed forever. He can never be a royal. Somebody expects pseudo dignity is forever middle class man. He may have anything, but he is middle class and lower middle class. Listen carefully. Understand pseudo dignity is stupidity సూడో డిగ్నిటీ ఇస్ అన్సైంటిఫిక్ సూడో డిగ్నిటీ ఇస్ ఇర్రీప్రొడ్యూసబుల్ ఇంటగ్రిటీ ఇస్ సైంటిఫిక్ ఇంటగ్రిటీ ఇస్ రీప్రొడ్యూసబుల్ ఇంటగ్రిటీ ఎంపవర్స్ యూ integrity empowers you listen running away from pain running towards joy is the pseudo journey into which you have been brainwashed pseudo dignity is the way society controls O humanity, liberate yourself from all these three. You will manifest best life on planet Earth and best life for planet Earth. Your consciousness. Will have a break. Super conscious breakthrough. You will have a breakthrough and you will experience super consciousness the day you stop seeking for joy and start seeking for peace. The day you stop all your efforts to move away from pain and start making yourself powerful. The day you start looking for integrity instead of pseudo dignity. This is the royal secret for manifesting success in everything. Whether health, wealth, career, relationships, success in the life, personal fulfillment for the others, fulfillment for the humanity, enlightenment, power manifestation, super conscious breakthrough, every level. Do not ask for pseudo dignity, ask for integrity. Do not ask for joy, ask for peace. Do not try to escape from pain, ask for powerfulness. I tell you, the good news I have for you is your idea of pain, idea of joy, both are delusion and unscientific, irreproducible. Anything which can't be reproduced, if you are running behind it, then you are just destroying your life. You are deluded. You are after delusion. Search for peace. You will get it. And the more you get it, more you will feel empowered. You will experience powerfulness. More peace, you will have a deeper impact on the society, humanity, life, and on yourself. Experience more peace, go for more peace. Very simple truth, but this is the royal royal truth. To have super conscious breakthrough, success in everything you want to achieve in the life. This will bring success for you in every level. You are all my dear ones. I literally see you all as Paramashiva. My own extension, with all the sincerity, honesty, I am telling you the truth. Search for peace. Every small effort you put for peace, not only you will get peace, you will feel empowered, strengthened, powerful. Understand? You will feel empowered, strengthened, powerful. Do not ever look for joy or ways to escape from pain, because both are delusion. Like how you have been brainwashed by society with the idea of pseudo dignity, you are brainwashed with the idea of joy and pain. Pseudo joy and pseudo pain. Look for peace. Look for powerfulness. Manifest intensity in your action. You will simply see you are blissful. You are empowered. You are intelligent. You are shining. As I said, today is not only New Year, it is beginning of new decade and new era post-pralaya. So take this message intensely. Every Shanti mantra, every mantra in Vedas starts with the word Shanti, Shanti, Shanti and ends with the word Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Not Sukha, Sukha, Sukha. No. It starts with Shanti and ends with Shanti. Understand? It starts with Shanti, ends with Shanti, because Vedic civilization, Hindu civilization teaches you to look for peace, shanti, to look for powerfulness and manifest intensity. Understand? Looking for joy is just going after something which is not there. Look for something which is scientific, really exists and reproducible, which is reproducible. Just simple, simple few words. Simple few words. Meditate on this. In the further satsangs, I'll expand. But this is Paramashiva's message for this year, this decade, this era. Work to find peace. Work to find powerfulness. Manifest intensity in your actions. You will manifest the state of Paramashiva. You will manifest the space of Paramashiva. You will manifest the being of Paramashiva. You will manifest the powers of Paramashiva. You will manifest the super consciousness of Paramashiva. You will manifest కైలాస పరమశివ. January 1st is too closely associated with my life and Sangha, Kailasa. One, from my mother's memory, January 1st seems to be my birthday, even though the new discoveries are showing the document we got from family astrologer is archived. That paper, that document shows it may be 2nd January, and unfortunately the birth record does not exist in the hospital. In those days the hospitals are not that organized in India, so it is more like a local elderly women, they take care of the delivery of the babies, and I was normal delivery, there is no medical attention needed for my mother when I was delivered. So it was done, attended by the local midwives, the elderly women, they attended the birth. So there was no documentation, only the astrologer's handwritten paper, the small slip, only that seems to be the written document available. And the son of the astrologer who wrote my horoscope is still alive. The original person, astrologer who wrote my horoscope, has passed away, but the son is still alive. He has retrieved these papers, the father's records, and from his documents the actual date seems to be Gregorian calendar, 2nd January 1234 midnight. The 2nd January midnight, 1234, means 2nd January entering into 3rd January, that night seems to be the time. But from my mother's memory, it seems to be like 1st January to 2nd January. Anyhow, only one thing is sure, I am born, that's all. And January 1st is the day Adi Kailasa was inaugurated. Many of our ashrams were inaugurated. Too many wonderful things have happened January 1st. This is the day we celebrate as a mission day, Nityananda Sangha Day. Even though the sankalpa I took for the Nityananda Sangha is December 31st, we celebrate January 1st because the Adi Kailasa Bidhi Ashram started. It was inaugurated on January 1st. The foundation stone was laid Deepavali Day in November. Inauguration was done on January 1st by the great Swamiji, Sri Shivakumara Mahaswamiji of Siddhaganga Mat. He was called as Nadadaduva Devaru, means walking God, who lived for 111 years. And Sri Sri Balagangadharanatha Mahaswamiji of Adichunchanagiri Mat. And Sri Shivapuri Swamiji, Shivapuri Mahaswamiji attended as representative of my guru, Sri Tiruchi Swamigal, Shivaratnapuri Mahaswamiji, because Shivaratnapuri Mahaswamiji himself, he was too old and he was not able to move around to attend many functions, so he sent his chief disciple, Sri Shivapuri Mahaswamiji, to grace on behalf of him. All of them came and attended and inaugurated the Adi Kailasa Nityananda Peetham. We have wonderful memories on this January 1st. So let's all celebrate this mission day and I have 32 proclamations today from all over the world. I have 32 proclamations from all over the world celebrating my birthday, Jayanti, and still pouring. We may have more than 100 by January 7th. Jayanti Mahotsava. Till today, we received 32 in our hands. First, I wanted to thank all those who sent their proclamations and letters in honor of the 44th Jayanti of Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism and his innumerable contributions for the upliftment of all humanity and for the revival of Kailasa nation. Seven from Karnataka, six from Tamil Nadu, three from Maharashtra, one from Delhi, one from Kerala, one from Gujarat, one from California, USA, two from New York, USA, one from New Jersey, USA, one from Florida, USA, total five from USA, and three from Nepal, one from Afghanistan, two from Malaysia, one from Australia, one from United Kingdom. So, these proclamations are from acclaimed Academy Award winning actress Miss Susan Sarandon. I sincerely thank you for your proclamation. And second is, I sincerely thank Miss Susan Sarandon, Academy Award winning actress and renowned activist. Thank you for your proclamation. All this we will be uploading in the Facebook and social media. You can see one by one. Thank you for Ma Kaladevi, New Zealand Ma Kaladevi, for coordinating. And Honorable Mayor Rich Chan, City of Milpitas, California, has sent his proclamation. Thank you, Mayor Rich Chan, City of Milpitas, California. Thank you for your proclamation message. And commendation letter from New York, NYUSA, Mrs. Hazel Duke, civil rights activist and co-chair of Coalition for Hate-Free Internet. Thank you, Mrs. Hazel Duke. Thank you. Next, I have commendation letter from New Jersey, USA, Dr. Stephanie R. Coney, founder and CEO of National Stop the Violence Alliance. Thank you for your commendation letter. Next, Mr. Pedro Diaz Ballester, President of Dominican International Business Federation from Florida. Thank you for your commendation letter. Mr. Najib Nouri, lawyer from Afghanistan. Thank you for your commendation letter. Most Venerable దత్తు కే శ్రీ ధమ్మరత్న చీఫ్ హై ప్రీస్ట్ ఆఫ్ మలేషియా బుద్ధిస్ట్ మహావిహార థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ యువర్ కమెండేషన్ లెటర్ Malaysia Vegetarian Society, Mr. Rajkumar Sheth, President, Malaysia, thank you for your commendation letter. Mr. Mark Percy, CEO of BTP Advisors, London, UK, thank you for your commendation letter. Dr. Mahesh Bhandari, Tarnet branch president, Australian Labour Party, thank you for your proclamation message. Mr. Uttam Das Shrestha, president of ARCHID Organization for Children Development, Nepal, thank you for your proclamation message. Mr. Saroj Manandar, president of Heritage Conservation Society, Nepal, thank you for your proclamation letter. Mr. Nashir Maski, chairman of Saichik Pratishtan, Senior Secondary School, Kathmandu, Nepal, thank you for your commendation letter. Mr. Ramakrishnan, through Dr. Chellappa, President of Kerala Kaikola Mudali Sangam, thank you for your proclamation. Blessings. Dr. D. Vimalanadan, Vice President of All India Velalar Mudaliyar Pillaimar Singundar Association, thank you for your proclamation. P.K. Saravanan Kandasamy, they were Secretary of Marathi Tamil Sangam Education Trust. Thank you for your proclamation. Thank you. Ma Ganapati, General Secretary, Thekkidar Kalvi Panbattu Kalagam. Thank you for your proclamation letter. My blessings. P.K. Saravanan Kandaswamy Thevar, founder of Vallal Panditurai Thevar Memorial Library, thank you for your proclamation letter and blessings. Mr. Sevalier Arunachalam, chairman International Mudaliyar and Pillaimar Association, thank you for your commendation letter, my blessings. Mrs. Kirti and Mr. Yogesh Goyal, Director and Chief Trustee, Sattvic Life Sciences Trust, thank you for your proclamation letter. Blessings. P.V. Samson, Paduka Mandir, Shiva Temple, thank you for your proclamation letter. Blessings. Dr. Sri Nitya Sarvananda, Managing Director, Sarvam Multisystem of Medicine and Research Institute. Thank you, Sri Nitya Sarvananda, for your proclamation message and my blessings. And Mrs. Priyanka and Mr. Rohit Vishwanath, Directors of Cloudleo Technologies. Thank you for your proclamation message. Blessings. Mr. Shyam Kumar, PK, founder of Inner Truth, thank you for your proclamation message, my blessings. Mr. Suresh Palamal, President Palamal Foundation, Gujarat, India, thank you for your commendation letter, blessings. Murugan, Secretary, Cheetah Camp, Shivalayam, thank you for your proclamation letter and blessings. தவதான் ரசமணி, பிரசிடென்ட், திரு வேல்முருகன் டெம்பிள் ட்ரஸ்ட், தமிழ்நாடு. தேங்க் யூ ஃபார் யுவர் ப்ரொக்ளமேஷன் லெட்டர் அண்ட் பிளஸ்ஸிங்ஸ். டாக்டர் கிருஷ்ணா ஷாமாராவ், மெடிக்கல் டைரக்டர் ஆஃப் ஐங்கா ஹெல்த் ஃபவுண்டேஷன். தேங்க் யூ டாக்டர் ஃபார் யுவர் ப்ரொக்ளமேஷன் லெட்டர் அண்ட் மை பிளஸ்ஸிங்ஸ். டாக்டர் சேத்தனா, co-trustee of Ainga Health Foundation, thank you for your proclamation message and my blessings. G. Manigandan, managing director, Manolaya, thank you for your proclamation message and my blessings. Dr. Shanti, consultant obstetrician, gynecologist, former associate professor at அம்பேத்கர் மெடிக்கல் காலேஜ், தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் யுவர் ப்ரொக்ளமேஷன் லெட்டர் அண்ட் மை பிளஸ்ஸிங்ஸ். மிஸ்டர் சுரேந்தர் கிருஷ்ணன், செக்ரட்டரி, ஸ்ரீ ஐயப்ப சேவா சங்கம், தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் யுவர் ப்ரொக்ளமேஷன் லெட்டர் அண்ட் மை பிளஸ்ஸிங்ஸ். தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ ஃபார் சென்டிங் ப்ரொக்ளமேஷன் லெட்டர்ஸ் அண்ட் மெசேஜஸ் அண்ட் ஐ ஆம் ரிசீவிங் டன்ஸ் மோர். மேபி ஃப்ரம் tomorrow I'll share more and more. Till today this is what we received. We may be getting more than 100 by January 7th, Jayanti Mahotsavam. Thank you all sincerely for supporting Kailasa, standing by us through your proclamation letters. My blessings, love, respect for all of you. இந்த இனிய ஆங்கில புத்தாண்டு நல்நாளில் மற்றும் நித்யானந்த இயக்கத்தின் துவக்க தினமான ஜனவரி 1 தேதி உங்கள் அனைவரையும் வரவேற்று வாழ்த்தி மகிழ்வதில் பேரானந்தம் அடைகின்றேன். இந்த நாள் ஜனவரி 1, 2021 ஆங்கில புத்தாண்டு துவக்கம் மட்டும் அல்ல, ஒரு தசாப்தம், 10 துவக்கம். இது வெறும் ஒரு புத்தாண்டு துவக்கம் அல்ல, 10 துவக்கம். அதற்கும் அப்பாற்பட்டு இந்த மிகப்பெரும் பிரளயம் முடிந்திருப்பதனால் ஒரு புது யுகத்தின் துவக்கம் என்றே இன்றைய நாளை நாம் சொல்லலாம். இன்றைய தினம் ஜனவரி 1, 2021 வெறும் புத்தாண்டு தினம் அல்ல, இது 10 துவக்க தினம் மற்றும் புது யுகமே துவங்கும் நன்னாள். நமது கைலாசத்தை பொறுத்தவரை இந்த நாளில்தான் ஆதி கைலாசமான விடுதி நித்யானந்த பீடம் துவங்கப்பட்டது. இந்த நன்னாளில் நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் சிவபதத்தில் இருந்து சிவபாதம் அடைந்து சிவசக்திகள் மலர்ந்து பரமசிவமயமாய் வாழ்ந்திட ஆசீர்வதிக்கின்றேன். பரமசிவ பதத்தில் இருந்து பரமசிவ பாதத்தை அடைந்து பரமசிவ சக்திகளில் மலர்ந்து பரமசிவத்துவத்திலேயே நிலை பெற்று பரமசிவ உணர்வில் லயித்து பரமசிவானுபூதியில் நின்று பரமசிவ கைலாயத்தில் மலர்ந்து எல்லா நன்மைகளோடும் இருந்து நித்யானந்தத்தில் நிறைந்து நித்யானந்தத்தில் மலர்ந்து நித்யானந்தமாகிட ஆசீர்வதிக்கின்றேன். ஆனந்தமாக இருங்கள். So, I have one more release tomorrow. As per the astrologer's document, we will be celebrating my birthday. So now we will have 3 birthday celebrations. One from my mother's memory, January 1st. 2 from the astrologer's document, January 2nd. And actually, actual Janma Nakshatra. That will come every year on different days. That is Jayanti. We will be celebrating all the three because we Hindus don't get tired for celebrating. For any reason, we celebrate. We celebrate, we celebrate. If somebody comes up with some other new discovery, a new document, no, Swamiji's birthday is March 13th, then we will celebrate that also. That's all. We don't feel tired or get bored to celebrate. And every day is Jayanti for us. Every day is Janmadina for us. So we have one more reason to celebrate. That's all. And every new discovery is one more reason for us to celebrate. So tomorrow, as per the astrologer's discovery, from his archives in India, that one good tradition is there. Astrologers are like hereditary. For generations, they do this same. So my family astrologer, his father wrote my father's horoscope. His grandfather wrote my grandfather's horoscope. It's like a generation. From the time of palm leaves, then the bamboo paper, then modern paper, all documents are there in their house. So from his archives, he pulled out and got a slip from his father's handwriting. So based on that document, we will be celebrating tomorrow, January 2nd, midnight, auspicious Sarva Mangala Darshan, Ganapati Bhavasamadhi Darshan, Mahaganapati Bhavasamadhi Darshan and Paramashiva Darshan, Sarva Mangala Darshan. You can register. It's free for all. You can just register and get free e-passport and attend. I am inaugurating the landing page for this Sarva Mangala Darshan. The preparation will start at 9 p.m. Indian Standard Time, January 2nd, the landing page. Yes. You are all welcome to register and attend the Sarva Mangala Darshan of Mahaganapati Bhava Samadhi Darshan and Paramashiva Darshan. My blessings to all of you. So, with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Suddhatvaita Saivam, the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness, and Kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.